Now we're going to talk about basic factoring. And to begin this discussion, I want to start with a problem that you should already know how to do. Let's multiply out this x times this quantity, 3x plus 7. The way to do this is you take the x and you distribute it through the parentheses. What that means is you take x times 3x and you get 3x squared. And then you do 7 times x and you get 7x. That process is called multiplication, or maybe distribution. Well, factoring is doing just the opposite of that process. Factoring is just backwards multiplication. So sometimes you have this line here, but what you really want is it written out like this line right here. So let's try it. Let's look at 3x squared plus 7x. How can we go about reversing that multiplication that we just did? Well, what you have to do is you have to notice that there's a factor of x in each of these two terms. Now, you don't have to write this step every single time, but it helps to recognize that 3x squared can be written as 3x times x, and 7x can be written as 7 times x as well. Now that you know there's a factor of x in each one of these terms, you can do what we call pulling that factor out of each term. We pull this x and this x out of the parentheses right there, and what we're left with inside of the parentheses is this 3x and this plus 7. Well, how do we know that what we just did was a legal operation? Well, we know how to multiply really well. So what we can do is we can think, what would happen if I multiply this thing back out? And we already know the answer. But you would take this x and multiply it by 3x. It would give you 3x squared. And you'd take that same x and multiply it by 7, and it would give you 7x. So everything checks out. All right, I know this might be a little confusing at first. Let's take a look at another example. I would like to factor 3x squared minus 6x. And the first thing you might notice, of course, is that there's a factor of x in each one of these two terms. In other words, we could write this as 3x times x minus 6 times x. Maybe it'd be better to use a little bit of color when doing this. Now both of your common factors are in. Okay, so you can take that factor of x out of each term by pulling it out of some parentheses. And what we're left on the inside with is just 3x minus 6. Now that's all great, and I'm almost ready to box this answer up, but you notice there's actually a factor of 3 in each one of these terms as well. In keeping with the color scheme, what we can do is we can write 3x as 3 times x, and we can write 6 as 3 times 2. Now you'll notice that each term has a factor of 3 in it, and it's in green. And now we can pull that 3 out of the parentheses as well. What we're left with inside the parentheses is just the x minus the 2. Okay, so to make it look all the same color now, the way we would normally write this is with a 3x times the quantity x minus 2. Now what some of you may be asking is, couldn't we have recognized from the very beginning that x wasn't the only factor that these two terms had in common? The biggest factor that these two terms have in common is actually 3x, and you might notice that from the very beginning. And that would be really great. So let's do it that way. Let's say you recognize right off the bat that each of these two terms has a 3x as a factor. Well, you can write 3x squared as 3x times x, and you can write 6x as 3x times 2. Fantastic, so we can pull that 3x out in front of some parentheses, and what we're left with inside the parentheses is an x minus a 2. And the way that we would normally write this without the color is just like that. Hey look, it's the same thing. Mathematics actually works. So to summarize what we just did, we did the problem two different ways. The first way, we recognized that x was a common factor for both of these terms, and we pulled that x out. Then, before we could box our answer, we recognized that 3 was also a common factor. So we pulled that 3 out of each term, and we pulled it out of the parentheses as well. The second way we did this problem is we recognized from the very beginning that 3x was the biggest factor that was shared by both of these two terms. You can pull that 3x out of each term, and then pull that 3x out of your parentheses, and we're ready to box both of our answers, because either way you do it, you get the same thing. Okay, let's try another one. Let's try 4a cubed plus 2a squared plus 8a. Let's think about this for a minute to try to come up with what is the biggest factor that all three of these terms share. We call this number the greatest common factor. And what is it? Well, I think it's a 2a. You'll notice that all these numbers are even numbers, so they each have a factor of 2 in them. You'll notice that the variables in each term each have an a in them. Okay, so let's rewrite this expression by taking a 2a out of each one of these three terms. You'll notice that you can write 4a cubed as 2a times 2a squared. You can write 2a squared as 2a times a, and you can write 8a as 2a times 4. What are you left with? Well, you pull a 2a out of each one of these three terms, and you pull them outside of the parentheses, and you're left with 2a squared plus a plus 4. And that's it. That's your answer. Now, when you do a whole bunch of these problems and you get pretty good at it, you typically don't have to write in this step right here. A lot of times what people will do is they'll jump from their expression, they'll recognize the greatest common factor, they'll pull that 2a out of the parentheses, and they'll write in the parentheses what would be left. For now, it's a good idea to write it out with this step. Let's just do one more example. Let's factor 4x plus 2. It's simpler, but it can give people issues sometimes. The first thing to do is to recognize what the greatest common factor is. Notice that there aren't any x's in this term right here, so x won't be included in the greatest common factor. Well, the only thing that's shared by these two terms is a factor of a 2. So the greatest common factor is 2. Now, if we pull a 2 out of 4x, you'll notice that 4x can be written as 2 times 2x. Now, pulling a 2 out of this term right here is a little bit tricky. You can actually write 2 as 2 times 1. So now when you pull your 2 out of your parentheses, what you're left with inside the parentheses is a 2x plus a 1. And the answer, if you factor 4x plus 2, is 2 times 2x plus 1, and that's it. Again, if you're not sure about your answer, try to multiply the thing back out. You're really good at that now. So if you multiply 2 by 2x, you get 4x. If you multiply 2 by 1, you'd get the plus 2. So you can always double check your answer to make sure that it's correct. All right, let's get you a video quiz. Here it is. You just want to factor the same way we did above, just by removing a common factor. And you don't want to remove any common factor. You want to remove the greatest common factor. All right, good luck. I'll see you in the next video.